The following is a presentation of Hockey Night in Canada in association with the NHL and Sportsnet.
How you choose to express yourself, it's all your
Selena Gomez and The Scene, naturally the name of the song. There's Ilya Samsonov. Obviously, he's focused tonight. Nashville Predators 9-2 in their last 11 games. Tremendous. Toronto was outshot 41-22 Thursday, but beat Ottawa 4-3. The Leafs have been outshot by 15 or more 8 times since the start of last year and have won every one of them. They've got a great offense. So does Detroit. They are second in the NHL right now with 3.84 goals per game, and they've added Patrick Kane. Take on the Ottawa Senators, playing just their 6th road game of the year. Is that crazy? Notwithstanding a trip overseas 2 months into the year and just their 6th road game tonight. We've got Montreal into Buffalo tonight, and those are two young hockey teams. In fact, the Sabres and Habs rank 1-2 most points, players 24 or younger. Buffalo's got 104 from their 24 and under crowd. Montreal's got 95. So that's the game in Buffalo. And then tonight we'll all convene for the Carolina Hurricanes, who have that great post-game celebration. A thought on that in just a second. And the Vancouver Canucks, our doubleheader game tonight on Hockey Night in Canada, presented by Rogers. Good evening with Jennifer. By the way, Kelly Rudy's back next week. He did work the Flames, lost to the Devils this
afternoon.
Tired
of me already?
Yeah, Ellie, no, I'm not slagging you. Ellie Friedman, Kevin Bieksa. Gary Galley's home. He lost his mom, Gail. So, Gary, again, our love to you and the family. Colby Armstrong did the game last night, Pittsburgh, Florida, and it was Patrick Hornquist night. They were telling the story of how Hornquist would always go along the bench with the butt end of his stick, knock over the water bottles.
It's like slap shot.
Yeah, he drove Sidney Crosby crazy because Crosby has to have always the water bottles.
Oh, he did it to his own team.
He did it to his own team to get Crosby fired up. Isn't that a funny story? So, Colby, you told that last night, and we'll look forward to your work in Buffalo this evening. Here's another water bottle moment for you. Dustin Wolf, who grew up just outside of San Jose, California, has a great goalie water routine. Selivanov and he combined on this after his victory Thursday night. He's an amazing story. He went way late in the draft, 214th. His mom, Michelle, kept looking at all the goalies going ahead of him who didn't have better records, didn't have better resumes. Why did the others go ahead? Because they were taller. But Wolf has made it to the NHL. They did lose today, but he's a fantastic story, and that's a great celebration. Obviously, Carolina at home games has a great celebration. You mentioned Patrick Kane, Showtime celebration, so we got a lot to look forward to as everybody ups their game. Exactly. Let's start our coverage with Kyle Bukoska, Scotiabank Arena in Toronto. Kyle, down to you.
Well, Ron, Toronto sports fans have had to digest some pretty disappointing news here today, including the reality that Joseph Woll has been sidelined with a high ankle sprain. Ilya Samsonov gets the net tonight. Tyson Barrie's back in for the Predators. Cody Glass returns to their lineup as well. Auston Matthews may not be Shohei Ohtani, but he can hit home runs, and he can score big goals. He went beast mode in this building a week ago, according to his head coach. And hey, was anyone tracking the flights that the Leafs' dads were on yesterday? Well, they're in the building here tonight as the annual Father's Trip has begun. That is one group no athlete wants to disappoint. Sean McKenzie, over to you.
Kyle, tonight in Hockey Town, American star power will be on full display for the Sens. It's no secret that Brady Tkachuk drives this team, and the numbers back it up. In 10 Sens that wins this season, Brady, 10 goals and 2 assists, just 2 pims. In 11 losses, 3 goals, 4 assists, 48 penalty minutes. When Brady goes, the Sens go. For the Red Wings, Patrick Kane will play game number 2. And when you're one of, if not the greatest American players to ever do it, you earn a little extra room in the dressing room, his stall between the honorary stalls of Howe and Lindstrom. Not a bad place to hang up your skates. We'll see what Showtime has in store for us tonight. Now let's send it to Ken Reeves.
Hey, Sean, Toronto, they didn't get the big show this week, but Buffalo, they have the big show back. 6'6", 220-pound Tage Thompson returns to the Sabres lineup this week. Second game back, totally sniped one, his 7th of the year. An 18-game Sabres, hoping he can regain that touch, that 47-goal touch from 1 year ago. As for the Canadiens' top sniper, Cole Caulfield, just 3 goals in his last 19 games. Rasmus Dahlin back in the lineup for the Sabres tonight after missing one game. Yoel Armia in for Mike Pizzetta. Ron.
Ken, thanks kindly for that. The Ohtani contract, as you know, $700 million U.S., just shy of $1 billion Canadian. The value of one-way contracts handed out on day one of NHL free agency last year, $569 million. A rare beauty, that Ohtani.